شريك لك
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are to talk about the most blessed day of the days of the Hijjah. Rather, خير يوم طلعت عليه الشمس, the best day on which the sun ever rose on. Don't be confused with the other hadith that talks about the day of Jumu'ah. This meaning during the week. The best day of the week is the day of Jumu'ah. But the best day of the year is the day of Arafah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود. سورة البروج, by the sky and its stars, and by the promised day, and by the witness and the witnessed. في سنن الترمذي من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم says, the promised day, اليوم الموعود, is the day of resurrection. The witness is the day of Jumu'ah, and the witnessed is the day of Arafah. Here is, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking an oath on the day of Arafah because of its virtue, because of its significance, because of its importance. Brothers and sisters in Islam, also the majority of the scholars of tafsir from our righteous predecessors such as Ibn Abbas, Mujahid, Ikrimah and others, they explained the oaths, plural, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took in Surah Al-Fajr, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ عَشْرُ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ, the days of the Hijjah. And some of the scholars, they said also the 10 nights of Ramadan and the 10 days of the Hijjah, both. Because in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, there is the night of Laylatul Qadr. It's better than 1,000 months, 84 years plus. And in the 10 days of the Hijjah, there is a day which is the best day of the year. Here's what I'm looking for. وَالشَّفَعْ وَالْوَتْرْ. Ibn Abbas and these scholars from our righteous predecessors of tafsir, such as Ikrimah and Mujahid and others, they said الشَّفَعْ is the day of Eid, which is the day of Nahr, يوم العيد. والوتر is the day of Arafah. Again, I'm just making sure that you understand, because of the virtue of this day, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking an oath by it. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the day of forgiveness for those who are in Hajj and those who are not in Hajj. في صحيح مسلم, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about fasting the day of Arafah. But we know that this applies only to those who are not in Hajj, because it is not a sunnah to fast this day if you are in Hajj, based on Hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah, when في صحيح مسلم, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was delivering his sermon on this day, he called upon water and he took a drink in front of everybody, as if he's letting them know, you are not to fast this day if you are in Hajj. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam answered the companion Abi Qatada, who asked him about the virtue of fasting the day of Arafah for the non-Hajji. He said it expiates the sins from the past year and the coming year. What about the people in Arafah, brothers and sisters in Islam? Ya Allah. Listen to this hadith. Hadith that I quoted earlier, a lengthy one, but I will take the piece that deals with the day of Arafah. Two companions, they came. Hadith ibn Umar, fi mu'jam al-Tabarani al-Kabir, wa musnad al-Bazzar, and also fi sahih ibn Hibban. Two companions, one from Thaqif, one from Al-Ansar, they came and they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the virtues of the deeds of Hajj. They wanted to know what we get if we stand in the mountain of Arafah until the sun sets. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, brothers and sisters in Islam, he said to them, أَمَّا وُقُوفُكُمْ بِعَرَفَاتِ عَشِيَّةَ عَرَفَاتِ As for you standing on the mountain of Arafat until the sun sets, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْبِطُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will descend on those who are standing to the lower heaven. Do we believe that Allah descends? Absolutely. Do we know how? No, we don't. Should we ask? No, we should not. But we believe it. لا تشبه ولا تعطل ولا تكيف كل ما دار ببالك فالله بخلاف ذلك. Don't try to visualize. Everything that you visualize, Allah is above that. سبحانه وتعالى. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Nothing is like him, and he is the all hearer, the all seer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the lower heaven on those who are standing in the mountain of Arafah. And then he addresses his angel saying, Unduru ila ibadi. Look at my servants. Atawni shu'tan ghubura. They came to me dusted and disheveled. Min kulli fajjin amiq. From every distant valley, far away. They came from America. They came from Australia. They came from Pakistan, from Afghanistan, far away. يرجون رحمتي, يرجون جنتي. They want my Jannah. يرجون مغفرتي. They want my forgiveness. My angels, bear witness. Even if their sins are as many as the drops of rain, لو أن ذنوبهم مثل قطر المطر ومثل عدد الرمل ومثل زبد البحر غفرتها لهم. If their sins are as many as the number of sands, pieces of sand in earth, the number of the drops of rain, the number of the foam of the sea, I have forgiven it for them. And I also have accepted their intercession for anyone for whom they made dua for. Ya Allah, what a virtue. What a virtue. Ya ikhwa, fi sahih Muslim, hadith Aisha radiallahu anha, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam says, ما من يوم أكثر أن يعتق فيه عبد من النار من يوم عرفة. There is no other day on which Allah will free necks from the hellfire than the day of Arafah. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَدْنُو. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends. فَيَقُولُ يَا مَلَائِكَتِي. Look, my angels. هَؤُلَاءِ عِبَادِي. These are my servants. أَتَوْنِي شُعْثًا غُبْرًا. They came to me disheveled and dusted. أُشْهِدُكُمْ يَا مَلَائِكَتِي أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. That is why, subhanAllah, brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, once he spoke about the best dua that you can make on this day is to praise Allah. قال sallallahu alayhi wasallam, والحديث في مسند أحمد من حديث عمرو بن شعيب عن أبيه عن جده وجده هو عبد الله ابن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. The best of supplication is the supplication that you make on the day of Arafah. وخير ما قلت أنا والنبيون من قبلي لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. لا إله إلا الله. Where is the dua? You're only praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're only praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this day, brothers and sisters in Islam. Yes, the day of Arafah is the day of forgiveness for those who are in Hajj and those who are not in Hajj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you that new beginning on this day, brothers and sisters in Islam. That is why you must be careful. You must be careful that you do not sin on this day. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was talking to Al-Fadl, the brother of Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiyallahu anhuma, when he saw him staring at women, the hadith fi Musnad Ahmad, the narrator is Abdullah ibn Abbas, and after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised him not to do this, then he told him, Yabna akhi, the son of my brother. Of course, this is a term that the Arabs use. Inna hadha al-yawm, on this day, من ملك سمعه وبصره ولسانه غفر الله له. Whosoever guard his eyes, guard his tongue, guard his hearing, Allah will forgive him. And that is why, brothers and sisters in Islam, towards the end of the day, once you're done with standing and making dua sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this day, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to those who are leaving the mountain of Arafah, As-sakina, as-sakina, slow down, don't rush, don't harm anybody. Let's take a short break and come back and talk about this blessed day. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك لا شريك لك.
التلبية, as we all know, is when a Muslim would say لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. Should not say that. Every Muslim should perform Hajj, and when we are performing the Hajj, we need to reach this perfection by seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, by seeking help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and making sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, and we do not know what is good for us. The Kaaba is not the bricks that is being built. The Kaaba is what is behind, or what's behind the meanings of Al-Kaaba, the first house of worship. If a person would know the wisdom behind every move that a person do in matters of worship, then where's the submission comes into the full meanings of it. To remember what Hajar, the wife of Ibrahim alayhi salam, when she went from the Safa to the Marwa, so concerned and disturbed about the affairs of her child Ismail, when he was laying some place between the Safa and the Marwa, crying because of the shortage of food and water.
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome back. We're talking about the best day of the best days, the day of Arafah. The most blessed days, the most blessed day of the most blessed days, the day of Arafah, the best, brothers and sisters in Islam, because of the amount of forgiveness and mercy. Hear this hadith. Al-hadith fi musnad Abi Ya'la al-Mawsili rahimahullah. Hadith Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anh. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and it looks like this hadith, يعني it happened, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made that statement on the day of Eid, or one of the days of Mina, أيام التشريق.
He called upon his companions and he said to them, أتاني جبريل آنفا. Jibril just visited me. وأقرأني من ربي السلام. And he delivered السلام. He delivered salam to me from السلام, from the source of peace, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he told me the following. وأخبرني أن الله قد غفر لأهل عرفات وأهل المشعر الحرام وضمن عنهم التبعات. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven all the sins of those who stood on the mountain of Arafat and those who overnighted, provided that they do not have a permission to leave early on al-Muzdalifah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantees that they will take care of their injustices. Remember, the injustices is something that you have to take care of. The forgiveness of Allah does not engage or does not get you freed from the injustices that you committed against other people. You cannot go and steal people's money and say, oh Allah, forgive me. You have to give the money back. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guaranteed that you will take care of this. The scholars of hadith, they say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant those people who stood in the mountain of Arafat and those who overnighted in al-Muzdalifah that they will take care of these injustices upon their return. If he owed money, Allah will bless him with money and he will grant him tawfiq to pay it back. If he has harmed somebody, hurt somebody, caused somebody harm, he will fix his relationship with him or with her. وَضَمِنَ عَنْهُمُ التَّبِعَاتِ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anh wanted to know, Ya Rasul Allah, أَهَذَا لَنَا خَاصَّةِ. Is this quality or privilege is only for our generation because you're making hajj with us, O Messenger of Allah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, هِيَ لَكُمْ وَلِمَنْ أَتَى مِنْ بَعْدِكُمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. This is for you and for anyone who comes after you until the day of resurrection, brothers and sisters in Islam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Yawm Arafah is a day of Eid for the Ummah. Yes, ورد في السنن بسند صحيح. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يوم النحر ويوم عرفة وأيام التشريق عيدنا أيام أكل وشرب. The day of نحر, the day of sacrifice, which is the 10th day of the Hijjah. The day of Arafah and the 3 days of Tashriq are our Eid. We eat and drink and joy. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Arafah is the major pillar of Hajj. في سنن أبي داود والترمذي والنسائي من حديث عبد الرحمن بن يعمر رضي الله عنه, he said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sent a caller to call amongst the people who are standing in the mountain of Arafah to make sure that they understand Al-Hajj Arafah, Al-Hajj Arafah, Al-Hajj Arafah. The major pillar of Hajj is Arafah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, one final piece about this day, and I can talk about this day more and more. This is the day on which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed the deen, perfected Islam for you. Hadith Tariq ibn Shihab fi Sahih al-Bukhari, a Jewish rabbi came to Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, faqala lah, ya amir al-mu'minin, O commander of the faithful, ayatun fi kitabikum, a verse in your book, law nazalat alayna ma'shara yahud, lattakhadna yawma nuzuliha eida. If it was revealed on us Jews, we would have taken the day on which it was revealed a day of festivity, a day of Eid, a day of festival. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu asked the Jewish rabbi, what verse are you talking about? He said, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-Islam deena. Today I have perfected the religion for you. The religion is complete. You do not need to add, delete, or change. This goes to the brothers and sisters who introduce innovations into the religion. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you, ما تركت شيئا يقربكم إلى الله ويبعدكم عن النار إلا وأمرتكم به. I have not left one thing that will bring you closer to Allah, distance you from the hellfire, but I commanded you to do. وما تركت شيئا يبعدكم عن الله ويقربكم إلى النار إلا ونهيتكم عنه. And I have not left one thing which will distance you from Allah and bring you closer to the hellfire, but I made it unlawful for you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, anybody who introduces an innovation into that religion, what is he saying? Imam Malik, rahimahullah, Imam Dar al-Hijrah, he says, من ابتدع في الإسلام بدعة. If you introduce an act into that religion, and you see it a good act, فَقَدْ زَعَمَ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا قَدْ خَانَ الرِّسَالَةِ. Ya Allah. He's claiming that Muhammad has betrayed his message. That is why, ya ikhwa, في حديث أبي بكرة and حديث جابر, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called upon his companions, أَلَا إِنَّكُمْ مَسْؤُولُونَ عَنِّي. You're going to be asked about me. What are you going to say? In the day of resurrection, Allah will ask the people whether the messengers have delivered the message or not. وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. The companions answered by saying, نَشْهَدُ أَنَّكَ قَدْ بَلَّغْتَ وَأَدَّيْتَ وَنَصَحْتَ. We bear witness, Ya Rasulallah, that you have delivered, you have performed, you have advised, you have completed the religion for us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam raises his sababa, his finger, his sababa. Allahumma fashhad, Allahumma fashhad, Allahumma fashhad. Oh Allah, bear witness. Oh Allah, bear witness. What I'm trying to say, brothers and sisters in Islam, the Jewish rabbi sees that the deen is complete is a virtue. Sees that our religion, Islam, is completed is a virtue. Look at the followers of other religions in earth. Every year, they modify the religion. They changed it to fit the time. But our deen is complete, brothers and sisters in Islam. Ishahid, brothers and sisters in Islam. Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anh, answered the Jewish rabbi, and he said to him, by Allah, we know when this verse was revealed. And where this verse was revealed. This verse was revealed on the day of Arafah, on the mountain of Arafah, right before the sun sets. And this is already a day of Eid. I just quoted the hadith a minute ago. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi sunan. He said, Yawmun Nahri, Yawmun Nahri, wa Yawmu Arafah. وأيام التشريق عيدنا are our feast. And it was a Friday to begin with. It was a Friday. The day was a Friday. And we are, the day of Friday is a Eid for us. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the day of Arafah is when you are granted that new beginning. The day of Arafah, brothers and sisters in Islam, is a day that you must increase dua sincerely. Is a day that you must make tawbah. And don't be plastic with Allah. Go out there, brothers and sisters in Islam, on this mountain and share with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what you done wrong. Allah wants to forgive you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters in Islam, is more joyful with your tawbah than a person who's about to die in the desert. And he found a rescue. And he ended up misspeaking. He ended up talking in a way that could lead to disbelief. He said to Allah, you are my slave and I am your Lord. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, أخطأ من شدة الفرح. He made a mistake because of excessive joy. Allah is more joyful than this person. الحديث حديث أنس في الصحيحين. And this is the wording of Muslim. Allah is more joyful than this person because of your tawbah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, go there. Do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this day. Go there. and share your past with Allah. Let Allah know what you have done in the past. It's between you and Allah. Go to the side of the mountain and sit by yourself and face the Qibla. And it is recommended to have dua and raise your hand. Allahumma ighfir li, Allahumma arhamni, Allahumma ruddani maghfuran lah, Allahumma ruddani marhuma. And make dua for the ummah. Make dua for the Muslims. Make dua for the oppressed of the Muslims. Make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would grant the Muslims a new beginning, like He granted you a new beginning, insha'Allah. ثُمَّ أَفِيضُ مِنْ حَيْثُ أَفَاضَ النَّاسِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ. And remember, one of the acts that you should do after completing this day is doing a lot of istighfar. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, tomorrow insha'Allah we conclude the series, The Blessed Days of the Hijjah. We're talking about a very special surah in the Quran called Surah Al-Hajj. Don't miss tomorrow's episode, insha'Allah. We'll let you know what we want to share with you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن حجا مبرورا وذنبا مغفورا وسعيا مشكورا لبيك الله حجا مبرورا وذنبا مغفورا وسعيا مشكورا لبيك الله حجا مبرورا وذنبا مغفورا لا شريك لك لبيك شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك لبيك الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم says, the promised day, اليوم الموعود, is the day of resurrection. The witness is the day of Jumu'ah, and the witnessed is the day of Arafah. Here is, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking an oath on the day of Arafah because of its virtue, because of its significance, because of its importance. Brothers and sisters in Islam, also the majority of the scholars of tafsir from our righteous predecessors such as Ibn Abbas, Mujahid, Ikrimah and others, they explained the oaths, plural, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took in Surah Al-Fajr. Wal-Fajr, wa-layalin ashr, ashru dil-hijjah, the days of dil-hijjah, and some of the jurists, for those who are in Hajj and those who are not in Hajj. Fi Sahih Muslim, The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked about fasting the day of Arafah. But we know that this applies only to those who are not in Hajj. Because it is not a sunnah to fast this day if you are in Hajj. Based on Hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah, when fi Sahih Muslim, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was delivering his sermon on this day, he called upon water and he took a drink in front of everybody as if he's letting them know, you are not to fast this day if you are in Hajj. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam answered the companion Abi Qatada, who asked him about the virtue of fasting the day of Arafah for the non-Hajji. He said it expiates the sins from the past year and the coming year. What about the people in Arafah? Some of the scholars, they said also the 10 nights of Ramadan and the 10 days of the Hijjah both. Because in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, there is the night of Laylatul Qadr. It's better than 1,000 months, 84 years plus. And in the 10 days of the Hijjah, there is a day which is better than, which is the best day of the year. Here's what I'm looking for. وَالشَّفَعَ وَالْوَتْرِ. Ibn Abbas and these scholars from our righteous predecessors of tafsir, such as Akrima and Mujahid and others, they said الشَّفَعَ is the day of Eid, which is the day of Nahr, يوم العيد. والوتر is the day of Arafah. Again, I'm just making sure that you understand. Because of the virtue of this day, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking an oath by it. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the day of forgiveness. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are to talk about the most blessed day of the days of the Hijjah. Rather, خير يوم طلعت عليه الشمس, the best day on which the sun ever rose on. Don't be confused with the other hadith that talks about the day of Jumu'ah. This meaning during the week. The best day of the week is the day of Jumu'ah. But the best day of the year is the day of Arafah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود. سورة البروج, by the sky and its stars, and by the promised day, and by the witness and the witnessed. في سنن الترمذي من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه.